I'm going to quickly introduce our panelists for debate number one. Piyush Goyal is joining us from Amritsar. There he's on your screen. Shri R. Kesavan of the Congress Party will be joining us to take him on. Naresh Gujral of the Shiromani Akali Dal also joining Piyush Goyal from Amritsar. Sankarshan Thakur, roving editor of The Telegraph, and Hartosh Singh Bal, political editor of The Caravan magazine. Piyush Goyal, my first question to you and Naresh Gujral sitting there, and you're on the same side as well, not just in the same location. I mean, why don't you take on Priyanka Gandhi? Not one word on Priyanka Gandhi. Every day there is a comment from Priyanka Gandhi. She's entered the campaign, she's taking you on. It appears to me that the BJP wants to make this Rahul Gandhi versus Modi. Why? Is that easier? Is that an easier contest, Rahul Arnab, versus Modi?
Arnab, you make all the decisions yourself, so well, you can decide who is on their side. But unfortunately, the people of India have already jettisoned the Congress. I think the people of India have written the obituary of the Congress. They are looking for relief from the terrible mismanagement of the economy, of their lives, the massive corruption that they have indulged in all these years. Now with Sanjay Baru's book, Mrs. Sonia Gandhi stands exposed as the person behind all this corruption, all this mismanagement. She has also seen the immaturity that her son, whom she hoped to foist on the nation, has displayed. He tore up an ordinance that the whole cabinet and the core committee of the Congress had passed. He promised action against corrupt ministers and chief ministers who are today the Congress's candidates. It is very evident to the Congress that neither Mrs. Gandhi nor Rahul are cutting ice with the people. We most heartily welcome Ms. Priyanka Gandhi, actually Ms. Priyanka Vadra, as per Indian tradition, to come into the fray. But we just heard 2 days back her declining to contest against Mr. Modi and announcing that she never intended to contest.
No, she says today it's a battle for the heart of India. Amethi
and Rai
she says it's a battle for the heart of India, so she's clearly in the battle.
Now, if at all for the Gandhi clan, only those two seats matter because it's a fight for their very survival, then well, she's free to campaign in those two seats. But we would welcome her to campaign all across India.
So why do you keep pulling the focus down to Rahul Gandhi? Why? You see, I made in my opening remarks, I made an observation, Mr. Piyush Goyal, that it appears to me, and maybe Naresh Gujral can also explain this because he's very much on your side. Why do you keep pulling it down to Rahul Gandhi? Is it an easier contest?
Arnab, zara sun bhi liya karo yaar.
No, is it an easier contest?
Learn to listen also, Arnab.
No, is it an easier contest?
The obituary of the Congress is being written by the people of India. They can bring Rahul Gandhi. They can bring Miss Sonia Gandhi. They can bring Priyanka Vadra, and if they don't find any relief, they can even bring Robert Vadra. We are happy to take all of them on.
C.R. Kesavan, you want to make your opening remarks? You're letting that pass. So because C.R. Kesavan is letting that pass, I move on.
Not at all. I'm making my remark. My remark here.
No, I thought.
First thing,
I thought.
I want to respond with a slogan. Taking off from the manifesto which they released after the voting had begun, showing how personality-centric they are rather than, you know, policy-centric. They said, Ek Bharat Shreshtha Bharat. The people know the real slogan of BJP. It's Ek Vyakti Vibhajit Bharat. I'm really amused at the way the rank and file of BJP is panicking. The Congress president has given a statement. They were talking about the advertisements being given. You have Mr. Modi ji addressing virtual rallies from, you know, holograms all over the country.
Who's stopping you from doing that?
Virtual and
who's stopping you from doing virtual rallies?
Not at all concerned. Not at all. We are very happy with the statement.
Is it unethical to do?
It's a powerful statement. Clearly delineating the battle. Clearly saying what is this fight about? What is the soul? This is a fight for the soul. You have a party which is divisive and you have a party which is...
Mr. Kesavan, come to the point. Mr. Kesavan. Mr. Kesavan. Mr. Kesavan, please come to the point. No, 1 minute, Mr. Kesavan. And by the way, the trending subjects tonight, TV attack on one side was yesterday's, and tonight it's Main Nahi Mom. My question is that yesterday's televised address, speech, which Modi calls advertisement, which Jaitley says is something is what paid for, 3 minute speech addressed to the nation, that presented this doomsday scenario, Sankarshan, doomsday scenario. If the BJP comes to power, BJP will ruin Bharatiyata. No, Jaitley's response is Main Nahi Mom. No, no, 1 minute. Mr. Kesavan, why are you reacting to everything I'm saying? I'm only trying to get everyone into the debate. Are you on the back foot already?
Sure, go ahead.
Has Mana Imam put you on the back foot?
And the Congress party is too.
Okay, fine.
Ek Vyakti Vibhajit Bharat has put BJP on the back foot.
No, no, I thought, what is your line, by the way? I don't know your response line. I thought Kapil Sibal's line was Hum Nahi Modi. I thought that was your counterline.
Everybody knows. See, you need to have one counterline for Mr. Modi. You know, well, the man doesn't have an idea of geography or history,
Congress stands exposed. Congress stands exposed as a party bereft of even a line to go into the campaign. They stand exposed.
Oh, please, you didn't have a manifesto release.
They are not
release,
able
sir.
To announce a prime
you
minister
didn't have a
and
manifesto
candidate.
Release, sir.
They are shifting the goalposts, trying to search somebody who can appeal to the people and possibly get some sympathy from the people. But I think the way they have handled the country for the last 10 years, they shut their eyes to all the corruption and tried to claim credit for taking
Mr. Piyush Goyal, Mr. Goyal, Mr. Goyal.
I think it's high time.
No, Mr. Goyal. Mr. Goyal, I'm very intrigued. You, Mr. Jaitley, Narendra Modi, everyone almost seems to make it look like it's Sonia Gandhi has done something highly immoral and unethical by going on television and making an appeal.
Very true.
Not what is my question to Sankarshan and Hartosh is...
Sonia Gandhi, we welcome
Priyanka
Vadra,
but what's wrong?
We welcome Robert Vadra.
But what's wrong? I'm saying
my
what's
friend,
wrong?
We welcome them all.
Why are you going on about Robert Vadra? I'm talking about Sonia Gandhi.
No, I'm just mentioning that since they're running out of family members,
the
three
question
are already in the fray, don't seem
okay,
to
fine. So, Mike,
every new survey shows
Arnab
the BJP number going up and the Congress number falling. So, I'm just saying that maybe the fourth or fifth member, because in any case, they have nobody but family members. It's a dynasty which has been running this country.
No, Mr. Kesavan.
They have only family members. They have no other leaders.
Sankarshan and Hartosh. Are these two mistakes? Are these two mistakes, Sankarshan and Hartosh? Two mistakes. Mistake number one, question Modi's marriage. Mistake number two, a televised speech which the BJP uses to say that it is a sign of Congress party desperation and also uses it to say Rahul Gandhi has failed, so Sonia Gandhi is now coming to the party's defense. Are these critical mistakes of the Congress or are they signaling a new welcome Congress aggression? Sankarshan and Hartosh.
Well, you know, Arnab, frankly, the issue of raising Narendra Modi's marriage, you know, with me, the jury is out on that one. I told you the other night, there might be a technical issue to be raised here with the Election Commission, but taking it to the public stage, as Rahul Gandhi did, I thought was unseemly and would not help, in any case, would not help the Congress. Point number two, the drift of this election, Arnab, has been clear for a while now, and it is becoming clearer by the day. I am in Bihar now. I've spent all day in the field. There is definitely no resonance of this Sonia Gandhi, Priyanka Gandhi, Narendra Modi fight here. The issues are very local. The characters are very local. So much for that on national television.
No. So you are telling Piyush Goyal there's no Modi wave in Bihar. Okay, Piyush Goyal, hear that, please. Yeah, thank you.
No. I am not saying
any
such thing.
But the only thing is that
every opinion
poll seems to suggest the BJP alliance getting over 31 seats in Bihar. The mood of the nation today is for change.
Let me complete what I'm saying.
The mood of the nation is for a better life. People want their aspirations to be met.
Oh God, you're sitting in Amritsar, I'm sitting in Patna.
And they are looking for Modi as that agent of change, the agent who will bring in a better life for the people.
That of course should be your view as a BJP treasurer. I have no quarrel
with
that.
Well, the people who came to Patna to attend his rally, the people who came to Bhagalpur to attend his rally yesterday, I think they were unparalleled sabhas. The kind of popular support he's getting wherever he's going
in Bihar, Piyush ji,
is unprecedented in the history.
Mr. Goyal, I am sitting in Patna, and I don't know what I have said that has sparked you to say all of this. I have said only that the drift of this election has been clear for a long while. It is becoming clearer by the day. I do not know what you understand by that you take so much objection to. Two, as far as Sonia Gandhi picking up 3 minutes of advertising time to say what she's... Thank you. Please let me finish what I'm trying to say. Sonia Gandhi taking 3 minutes of time to say what she has to say, to me, is absolutely fair. The pity is that UPA too has so debilitated itself and has lost credibility so badly with corruption, with standstills, with all manner of mismanagement at all kinds of levels, that even the right things that they say, the cry for Hindustaniyat is not a bad cry, and it is under challenge. But coming from a Congress president's mouth, it has no credibility today.
Mr. Kesavan.
It's a sorry thing.
Mr. Kesavan. You see, the point is... Please, what Sankarshan is saying is something very fundamental. 10 years of malgovernance, several years of price rise.
5 years.
Right? 4 to 5 years of repeated scams. And then you can't pull out the issue of secularism and national unity at this stage and say, we are not in this for ourselves, we want to save the nation.
That's right.
We want to save the nation.
The campaign.
What were you doing for the last 10 years?
Let us please remember.
Were the scams reinforcing Bharatiyata? Was the price rise reinforcing Bharatiyata? Was a weak government reinforcing Bharatiyata? Is it Bharatiya to have scams, price rise, and a weak government, an ineffective, silent prime minister? Bad foreign policy?
Bharatiyata giving rights-based legislation to the people.
Don't keep repeating the RTI line.
Bharatiyata is giving right to employment for the people. Bharatiyata is giving, ensuring that manual scavenging is taken out and they are giving a proper livelihood.
I think we are getting a response from Naresh Gujral as well, from Amritsar.
I need to speak, Arnab. You don't let me. I have to ask one question. Why has the BJP flustered, unnerved, distraught, and feeling so down because the Congress president makes a statement? She is the president of the Congress party. And the problem is they want to camouflage this.
You should be very happy that you have flustered the BJP.
Let me ask you a question, Arnab. Today, Rajnath Singh ji met, Maulana Kalbeji in Lucknow.
They said,
we are okay with Rajnath Singh ji. They said, we fear Narendra Modi ji. That is the fundamental problem. They never answered the question, why did Maulana Kalbe, everybody took so much offense that Srimati Sonia Gandhi ji, Bukhari meeting, Imam Bukhari, today is...
I have one question for you. Mr. Kesavan, just 1 second, please. I'm the anchor. I ask questions. I don't take questions. But I'll ask you this. Today, Priyanka Gandhi says... It is a battle for the heart of India. Everyone's watching TV right now, Mr. Kesavan. So I'll ask you, please tell me, how did Suresh Kalmadi take us closer to the heart of India? How did A. Raja take us closer to the heart of India? How did Ashok Chavan of Kargil for Profit, Adarsh Fame, take us closer to the heart of India?
How did Amit Shah take us close to the heart of India with a statement?
You answer my questions.
Muzaffarnagar, when he didn't talk about... He said
because
it's not
Amit
about
Shah
development,
said we have to take revenge against the government which has
development.
Ruined
Amit
the lives
said
of
it's
the
about
people
not
of
development,
India.
But taking, So please, let us not digress here. The issue is
that
the BJP is
flustered
and rattled because the Congress president has brought the issue of the fundamental divide. This is a fundamental divide in this country, where people on one side fear Narendra Modi ji and his divisive politics.
How is corruption not a fundamental divide?
Mr. Murali Manohar Joshi has questioned him 3 days back. He said Mr. Modi's Gujarat model has failed.
How is what the CAG has said not a fundamental divide?
They can only clutch at some...
The problem is the BJP has tried to... The RSS has tried to foil Mr. Modi. They have failed miserably. BJP has failed miserably by fostering Mr. Modi, and they don't know what to do. They're left in the lurch, and they know they're going to go down with the sinking ship of Narendra Modi ji and his failed model.
So if that is the situation, why did Sonia Gandhi go on television? Why is she going on television? Why are you spending time on television putting out these ads if you have already won the election?
If you have a problem with the Congress
president, what is the problem with the politician going on television?
What is the problem with Sonia Gandhi speaking, making a statement?
We are getting Artosh and Naresh Gujral into the debate.
Going on television.
No, I don't think there's anything wrong.
I don't think there's anything wrong.
Why should any leader go on television?
Everyone is free to go on television.
Fine.
Not just fixed interviews.
One second, please. Naresh Gujral. No, 1 minute. I'm getting Naresh Gujral and Hartosh. 1 minute. I am getting Naresh Gujral and Hartosh into the debate. A fight for the heart of India is Priyanka Gandhi's line. Now, has Priyanka Gandhi unleashed this line a bit too late?
Arnab, Mrs. Gandhi is basically trying to save this private limited company, which is soon going into liquidation. All the shareholders can come in. We will do collective halal this time. The problem is what they are saying. She says that BJP and Mr. Modi are autocratic. Very strange. The whole nation knows how the office of the Prime Minister was diminished by Mrs. Gandhi. The book which has been released recently clearly shows that all the files were going to her. She was giving the orders. She had all the power and the poor Prime Minister only had the responsibility. And all the chits for the various scams were going from her office. So I'm very surprised that she calls Mr. Modi autocratic. Then she also calls him divisive while she runs to the Shahi Imam. So this is total hypocrisy.
What happened today?
And it's
what
an about act of desperation.
No, what about Priyanka's line
today? What
about today?
What happened today?
No, what about the emotional pitch?
What about today?
Hartosh,
what happened in Lucknow today?
Line. As I said,
no, what
this
about,
ship is sinking.
No, no, what about
and they
the
emotional
pitch?
What about Hartosh? Hartosh,
once and for all, what happened today?
Hartosh,
political party.
Mr. Gujral,
what about the emotional pitch? What
about
the emotional pitch?
I'm curious about one phrase of yours. This, what were you referring to when you said collective halal? I'm curious as a journalist.
I'm sorry. That slowly,
what do you mean when you
the voters of this country
collective halal
will bleed this party to death? Okay. I said slowly, as I've explained
God
what I've said.
I mean, if
slowly,
that is the word you wish to use.
The voters of this country,
if that is the word
the next
you 50, wish to
20
use,
days are bleeding this party
no, what's
to
wrong?
Death.
No, one second. Sankarshan, what's your objection?
If that is the phrase you wish to use, I said if that is the phrase you wish to use, good luck to you.
Well, Arnab, the fact of life is the Congress today is without any agenda, without anything to promise or show the people either as a track record
you
or as something which
no,
they
no,
can do in the next
no,
5 years.
You, today, no, no,
the fact of life is the BJP manifesto
today,
clearly outlines
no, no,
the
second.
Policies and programs
one minute.
Of a future government
no, no, one second. By
the people of India.
By the way, Sankarshan objected to the aggression
Congress,
of Naresh Gujral's language the
power,
otherwise, even when
place, which improves their lives.
Piyush.
I think it is time
very sad,
for the
very
people of India to know how divisive this Congress party has
Piyush,
been. And
Piyush,
for
you
that
are,
matter, did you observe
Piyush Goyal,
the subtle,
Piyush Goyal, you are covering for Naresh Gujral. I know that.
Bharatiyata.
I know you are covering for Naresh Gujral.
Look, there
no,
you
no, no.
I know you are providing friendly fire for Naresh Gujral because you think Sankarshan cornered him with the use of the word collective halal. Sankarshan objecting to the kind of aggression in that language, completely unusual from Naresh Gujral. Reflecting the political climate.
This is an election. This is not a halal, collective halal. This is an election by the people of India. Exercise of mandate.
I think you'll have to
exercise
learn to
of
take
franchise.
Acronyms.
I have never heard anyone use
acronyms.
Words like collective halal
the
in the process.
Is decimated.
And I, as an Indian, as a journalist, am appalled.
No, Mr. Piyush Goyal, Mr. Naresh Gujral, who I must say otherwise.
Yeah.
Just a minute. On most newsa panels, he's a picture of calm, poise, and restraint. When Naresh Gujral sits next to you and he says, collective halal, asked to explain, he says, we will bleed, the voters of this country will bleed the Congress party to death. You find that acceptable, Hartosh? No, one second. I know, Mr.
Kes.
No.
Congress.
Is this the language of a political contest? Is this the language of a political contest?
You fabric of India.
No, the voters will bleed the Congress party to death.
that the voters of India now want a Congress-mukt Bharat.
This is
the kind of vote you are seeing.
Mr. Kesavan comes in. Hartosh, sorry, I'm going to let Mr. Kesavan respond, then come to you. Mr. Kesavan is intervening.
They are getting
desperate. Mr. Kesavan.
BJP is making a classic mistake, Arnab. It happened in 1971. They said they made it personalized. They said Indira Hatawa. We said Garibi Hatawa. Now we are saying Bhook-mukt Bharat, Berozgari-mukt Bharat, Ashiksha-mukt Bharat. But I'll tell you one thing. The BJP is rattled by the Congress president's statement. And they say, we are, you know, in a fit of desperation. What does Mr. Modi do? Flying kites with Salman Khan. And when Salman Khan says he'll vote for Priya Darji, don't they have an agenda?